Welcome back, survivors. Don here again with another episode of The Dead Linger. I'm just going to continue where I left off, and you can see the prison yard is now full of zombies, so I gotta be careful. Now, if I can find my way out of here again, I gotta find the exit. Where is the exit? Okay, I think it's over here. Wow. Oh, my. Whoa. Holy smokes. Look at all the zombies. Okay, I better get my arse out of here. Yeah, there it is. Whew. Okay. So, I'm going to try to make my way over that shopping mall or that big store that I think is over this way. Wow. Okay. So maybe it's a good thing I didn't stick around the prison too long. It's just full of zombies. So yeah. Let us see if we can make our way safely over there. Now, you can see when you're running, the stamina goes down, but when you stop and rest for a moment, it goes back up. But, okay, I think, yeah, there it is up ahead to the right, just past the corner of the fence. Let's see, I gotta check behind me. Wow. Okay. Ah, there it is, straight ahead. It seems like a little town or something. And there is the shopping mall or the big store or whatever you want to call it. Almost there. So let's check it out, see what we can find. And I gotta keep my eye out for the zombie dogs, because they're quite fast and vicious, and they can bite you on the run. So, okay, jump up here. Okay, oh, it's a Leland store. Leland's. They're quite big, actually. So, should be some goodies in there. Now, let's see how my... Okay, my hunger level's good. Yeah. So far, so good. But, let us go in here. It might be a bit dark inside, so I might have to use my flashlight. Now, I'm just wondering if I should take out these couple of zombies here. Maybe. Got him. Come on. Got him. Okay, one more. Now, the sound sometimes glitches. Sometimes the sound doesn't always work when you shoot a gun, I notice. But, again, those are minor things that'll be fixed more as the game develops. Okay, I just turned on my flashlight, but I see there's another Zed coming after me. Now, I better reload. You gotta be careful, because the noise of the gun draws them. Okay, come on. You want some too? Well, do you feel lucky, punk? Well, do ya? Reload. Now we gotta keep an eye on the ammo. I got 6 rounds in the gun and 3 spare rounds, so, whoa. So I gotta be careful. Okay, there is one there. Oh, did I miss him? Yeah. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Okay, you can see it's pretty dark in here. Oh, boy. They're starting to swarm. Hey, you, get off there. Clean up in aisle 2. Oh, whoa. You want some too? You want some too? Boy. Uh-oh, I am out of ammo. Oh boy, I got two bullets left in the gun. So I hope I can find more ammo for this, or a different gun with other ammo or something. Now sometimes when you shoot them, they drop things. And I noticed this zombie, when I shot him, he dropped a lead pipe or something, but I already got a crowbar, so I'll just keep hold of my crowbar. And let's look around. Now there's a duffel bag, but I already got a good backpack. So I'm going to hold on to the backpack. Now there is another spare gun and ammo, so I will grab that and use that if I have to, because I only have two bullets left in the Magnum. Let's see, what is that? That is a 44. Contaminated Tundra Hawk. Contaminated items can hurt your character, actually. Raise your risk of infection. Uh-oh. I'm going to switch to my crowbar because I missed. Crap. He tagged me as I ran by. Okay, I got to get him. Come on. Come on. Down you go, pal. Yes. There he goes. Takes maybe about three good whacks with a crowbar to take them down. Now, one of the best melee weapons I found, if you can find it, I haven't found it this session, but is the fire axe. Whoa. Boy. Newman, is that you? Oh, okay. He went down. He fell in an odd way, so... That's okay. Base plant. Yeah. Okay, so let's look around, see if we can find some goods. Now, I don't want to really use that contaminated gun unless I really had to, because it says increases infection risk when worn. Well, in this case, it would be used probably, but, and my infection right now is still somewhat low, but. The higher that infection bar goes, the more chance you have to get infected when you're attacked by a zombie. So you want to try to keep that infection rate low. Now, what do we got here? Oh, hammer. I could use that because another duffel bag, but I'll just keep my backpack that I already got. Yeah, hammer's good for, like, if you find a house or something, and if you want to... If you find some planks or boards, you can barricade a house, like put them across the windows or the doors. But you need a hammer to do that. But also a hatchet or an axe is good for chopping down trees. Oh, he snuck up on me. Ah, crap.
Yeah.
I think I'm getting surrounded. And my... the problem here is my flashlight is battery is running low. Yeah, you can see it was right on the low. So good thing I just happened to be at the bay door here. There's some light. I can see what's happening. Oh, what? Where'd he go? Because oh, he climbed up. Hit and run. Where'd he go? Come on, one more hit. One more hit. Okay, I got him. Now, I know there's not a lot of variety to the zombie models yet, but they will add more as development continues. So you can have a whole different variety of zombies, because right now most of them just look like these bald zombies wearing jeans and black t-shirts. But sneaky. And sometimes you can see the graphics glitch when they try to... climb up or climb down, they can suddenly just pop out of view and into view. But like I said, those are just minor things that'll be fixed up later. We have a can of spam or something here. Oh, it is a pile of shit. I gotta like the sense of humor in this game. Yeah, what'd you eat?
Oh, I just ate a big pile of shit.
I don't know. I'll save that pile of shit for to eat when I'm really hungry, I guess. But I guess I'll eat a banana or something now. Let's see. Okay, you can see. Brings up my sustenance bar. So the higher that bar, the less hungry you are. So it's good to keep it up, because if it goes like too low, you can just sort of like drop away in starvation. You know, you don't want to fade away in starvation mode. So and we got a pear. I think it's a good pear. Yeah, good pear. So fruit is always good if you can find, like, but don't eat the rotten or the bad ones, because they can maybe hurt your health. Now, it seems like there's lots of duffel bags in here, but like I say, I already got a hardened backpack, so excuse me, so I don't need the duffel bag. But duffel bag's good, because, you know, it has a lot of ample space, but I like the hardened backpack I got now. And here's more. I'll take care of him. Now, it looks like we're in the loading bay area of the store here. Now, my flashlight is... Yeah, you can see how the flashlight battery will drain as you're using it. So, and you can see it can get quite dark inside. You can see I'm out of the light. It can be quite dark. So, yeah, you want to be careful when you use your flashlight. You're going to try to conserve that battery. Now, I see there's a few more things in the shelf. So the store is a great place to find, like... Now, what is this? If I can reach it, maybe I can... Yes, okay, so what I did was, because it was up on the top shelf, I couldn't grab it from down here, but what I did was jump up and make a grab in mid-air. So, there is another... Now, I'm going to drop this bad gun, the one that was increases the infection risk, because I guess... Oh, that revolver is no good either, because that is infected too. So I guess those weapons got covered in zombie goop or something. And is that an apple? Yeah, good apple, I think. I will take that. Now, the nice thing about the fruits, like apples and bananas, they don't take up as much room as like these big ass cans of chicken or the piles of shit. I get a kick out of that. How's my infection rate? I gotta be careful about that. You get hit too much, your infection rate goes up, and then there's a chance that if you get infected, you could turn into a zombie yourself, and that's not good. So, I'm going to switch back to my Magnum, now that I had a little ammo that I found for it. Let's see, I'll put that up here. Yeah, you can move around your inventory to sort of like create extra space, because sometimes when you pick stuff up, it creates gaps. Maybe I'll hold on to the 44 ammo, even though I don't need it right now, but in case I find a better pistol later. Now, so those guns are infected guns, because I guess they got covered in zombie goop, and I'm going to try to avoid using infected items if I can. Is that a good orange? Yeah, good orange. So yeah, I like the apples and the oranges, because and pears, because they don't take up so much space, but they can give you replenish your sustenance level fairly well. Now, I'd like to get a hatchet or axe, if you can find them, because you need them for cutting down trees. Now, what is this? Oh, I think it's a candy bar or something. Let us take that. It is a melted candemonium candy bar. Okay, well, I'll keep it just in case. And that looks like an apple there. Okay. So, I'm getting plenty of food now. but, now, if you're ever in a spot and you say, well, there's too much, I can't take it all, but you want to find a place to board up for the night or a house or something, you can, like I mentioned last time, you can look at your compass, look at the coordinates there, I guess that's like latitude, longitude, and then you can make a note of that, and then, so if you have to find your way back to it, you can say, well, oh yeah, that Leland store was at -7 and 7, and then you can make your way back if you can follow the coordinates. You know, it's something about survival horror games, you know, the toilet must always be filthy and grody. It's just sort of like a given in most any survival horror game I've ever played. It's like, yeah, can't have a clean toilet. It's always going to be a gross toilet. So, what am I going to do? Let me check the battery level. Okay, battery level is good. Now, I think maybe I'll take one more quick look. I think it's all just mostly food in here. So this is sort of like a grocery store or something by the looks of it. And a lot of it's empty, a lot of empty shelves. But like you've seen, I found some bits and pieces of food and stuff like that. And so what I'm going to do now is, now you see there's another store over there. And I think they call it a Swartz. Or the Schwartz, or may the Schwartz be with you. And usually that has some food and stuff in it too. But I got plenty of food now. So now I'm going to try to see if I can find a house to hold up in. But lots of zombies lingering out here. I'm going to head towards a house over here. It looks like I see way off in the distance. I don't know if you can see it there, but it looks like a farm with a silo. Sometimes they're good places to hold up for a while. But, now for houses, if I do hold up in a house, I typically like to find a two-story house and then hold up in the upper floor. In the upper floor. I said, because off in the distance, I don't know if you can see it, but it looks like a couple of zombie dogs, and they are vicious. They are fast and vicious, so I'm going to see. No, they haven't noticed me yet, so that's good. I'm going to try to stay away from them because they are fast, and you can be running away from them, but they run pretty much as fast as you and bite your arse as you're running, and they can raise your infection level too, of course, as you get bit. So I'm going to try to head over to this two-story house over here. And that might be a good place to hold up and secure, possibly. Now, if I was lucky to find a pile of wood or boards or something around, I could nail up some boards and planks over the windows and doors and fortify a house and secure myself, but I don't see any right away. Now, it's a good idea to check the garages. Oh, there's one of those new bikes. Now, I haven't actually rode a bike yet, but first I'm going to look into the house first. Maybe there's a crowbar. I already got a crowbar. Oh, it's two bikes. Okay. I might try one later, but first I'm going to look through the house. and close the door behind me and see if there's any. Whoa, he kind of startled me. Okay, take him out. Yeah, like I said, you're gonna see some weird glitches and stuff sometimes. Like he was sort of like a ghost zombie. He was half in the sunken into the floor, but they can still chase you around. Oh, I hear some banging. Now that's the great atmosphere of this game. It's like you'll be in the house and you hear the bang, bang, or smash of a window, and it's like, oh, you know you're in trouble because they're trying to break in and they're trying to get at you. There's a guitar, a G-tar. You can actually use that as a weapon in a pinch if you need to. It's pretty dark in here. A bathroom. Oh, there's one out there. He's trying to sneak in, but I will leave him there. And, boy, oh boy. There's a couple outside I can see. Oh, they're starting to swarm the house. And let's see, how's my space doing? There's a rifle with some ammo. I suppose I can take it just in case, because boy, you can hear them beating on the doors and trying to get in at me. Ah, perfect. Hatchet. Did you hear them smashing the window? Uh-oh. They're getting in. I'm gonna make a run upstairs and see if I can hold. I got two in one shot. Excellent. Oh, crap. Where'd he come from? I'm getting in trouble here. They smashed through the front door. Not good, not good. Oh, go upstairs. One of them bit me in the arse as I ran upstairs. Yeah. Go in here, quick. Oh boy, I'm in trouble, guys. what is that? Oh, it's a jacket. Oh, it's a police, it's a riot vest. Excellent. Good, gives me a little protection. Well, I'm gonna finish off this session here, guys. And if I can survive this, I will continue again soon with another episode of The Dead Linger. And I hope I won't be one of the dead lingering. Woo! Anyways, like, comment, subscribe, and we will see you again soon, hopefully. Bye-bye for now.